Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing certain details about how a specific illustration can guide you, how to prepare the ledger balances, and we'll be giving you certain details on that. So let's figure out with the illustration mentioned ahead. So when we talk about ledger preparation, we ideally talk about journal entries first, because journal entry is the base from which you further go ahead and prepare the ledger balances. Because from journal entries, you transfer the balances to the ledger posting, and that's how the ledger balances are closed. So we have an illustration here for your reference. Please mention to note that down so that you will be able to solve it on your own. Now let's figure the journal entries of that part first, but however, let's figure out the illustration first thing. So we have illustration in regards to Tina Enterprises. Now Tina Enterprises, in the first year project month, they have given certain details, or for the year 2019, they have given certain details here. You need to pass the journal entry first and then figure out how the ledger balance is supposed to be prepared. So when we talk about ledger balances, let's first understand each entry. You can note down each entry, and then further we can go ahead with the preparation of journal entries here. So the first entry refers to the specific date, known as September 1st, 2019. Invested 10,000 cash in business. This is the first journal entry that has to be passed. So you have 10,000 cash which is invested in the business. Now this is something which refers to creation of capital, because this is the capital that has been invested out of her own pocket. So Tina Enterprises, first entry September 1, 2019, 10,000 cash invested in the business. Let's figure out the next entry. On September 5th, they have purchased an equipment worth ₹12,000, out of which ₹5,000 has been paid in cash and the rest is on account payable. That means on credit, which is supposed to be paid later on, or which can be paid in part payments. So when we talk about equipment which has been preferred or purchased for ₹12,000, here there is an asset coming in. So you have to prepare the entry according to that, out of which you have part payment being done in cash, 5,000, and the rest 7,000 will be your account payable. So we'll figure out how the entry will be passed on and how the journal entries will be then figured out or to be transformed to the ledger balances. Let's figure out the third entry which has been mentioned here. Now on September 25th, they have paid 3,000 cash on the amount owed for the equipment. So if you remember, in the previous entry we had 7,000 balance on account payable, out of which they have paid ₹3,000 for the amount which is supposed to be owed on cash. Still 4,000 is left as a balance in the accounts payable. So that you have to keep in mind so that you can further go ahead and analyze what will be the closure balance. Now let's figure out the last entry. Withdrew cash ₹500 for personal use. This clearly states there has been some drawing. So we'll be passing the drawing entry, and there, as there is a cash that has been going out, that means we'll further go ahead and prepare the same thing ahead. Now let's figure out how the journal entry is supposed to be passed. You can open your notebooks and start noting down or start passing the journal entries for your reference. Until then, we'll be able to check whether your journal entries are matching the one which we have mentioned for your reference. Now the journal entries has been mentioned here. So if you remember, Tina Enterprises, the first investment or the first transaction refers to investment in business. That means 10,000 cash of investment in business. Here, there is a capital that has been created. If you remember, capital always has credit balance, hence capital account will be credited, and debit what comes in, something that is coming in. That means something that is coming in for the business, 10,000 is coming in for the business. So the entry will be cash account debit to capital account ₹10,000. This will be the first journal entry, cash account debit to rupees capital account ₹10,000. So when we talk about capital or capital amount being invested or anything amount being invested into the business, it will be a capital, and hence we have this specific entry being passed. Now if we recollect the second entry again, there was an equipment that was purchased which was for 12,000. So asset is coming in, hence the name of the asset has been already given, which is equipment's account. So equipment's account will be debited for the amount 12,000. Once this specific amount has been debited, we have paid certain amount in cash. That means we have already paid ₹5,000 in cash here. So we'll be crediting that amount, because that is something that is going out. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. That is the rule that has been followed. Also, there is a credit account that has been created so that we can pay up that much balance later on under the name of accounts payable. So we have mentioned accounts payable also in credit, which is supposed to be paid, and hence a liability showing a credit balance of 7,000. Now, if you refer the third journal entry, it stated that we have paid rupees 3,000 in cash towards accounts payable. Now that the liability was created, it had a credit balance of 7,000, out of which you have cleared of liability of 3,000. That means liability account will be debited again. Now, what is this liability? Accounts payable is the liability towards which we have made a payment of 3,000. Hence, account payable account debited to cash account because cash is going out and the amount will be 3,000. So, when you talk about accounts payable account being debited to cash account, that means you have cleared off that much of liability. So out of 7,000, 3,000 has been cleared off. 4,000 is the balance which will be shown in the trial balance under the accounts payable category. Now let's figure out what will be the last entry. There is a drawing that has been done. Now drawing is an expense for the business and hence there is certain interest that will be charged on it. However, the question doesn't demand for it, but drawing is still an expense. So drawings account debited to cash account because cash is going out. That means 500 cash has been withdrawn for drawings or as drawings, hence drawing account will be debited to cash account. Amount has been highlighted here. Now we'll figure out how many account titles do we have. As we have already clarified all the four journal entries for your reference, now we'll figure out how many account titles do we have and accordingly we'll prepare the ledger balances, that means the ledger accounts. So let's figure that out for your reference. So if you can figure out, there are five account titles. First, cash. Second, capital. Third, equipment. Fourth, accounts payable. And fifth, drawing. So we'll be preparing account titles as per the format that has been created. Now you can note down the format and you can start preparing the account titles and then we'll start with posting of journal entries. Let's figure out the first one or the first account title that we'll be creating. So we have created the first account title, that is capital. Now how to pass the journal entries here? As we recollect the first entry that we have passed, that means cash account debit to capital account. Hence, that means there is certain amount that has been invested into your business. That means there is certain amount that has been invested into your business, which forms the creation of capital. If you recollect that we already know that if there is a debit account, that means debit side of the trial balance or debit side of the journal entries and debit side of the ledger account as well. So debit entry will come on the debit side. That means the posting will happen on the debit side. Credit entry will come on the credit side. Let's go ahead and prepare all the account titles first and then we can start posting the journal entries. So we have already created capital account. Next, we'll be creating the next account title. So we have created three account titles for your reference now first and then we'll go ahead with the next two account titles being created on the next sheet. So the first part, that means the first journal entry. Cash account debit to capital account. Capital account has been credited. Hence, by specifically, we will be mentioning under the capital account, we'll be mentioning the journal entries. So my cash account has been mentioned here under the capital credit side. So if you recollect how the entry has been passed, cash account debit to capital account. So under capital account, you'll mention the opposite side, that means by cash account. And on the cash account, we'll be mentioning to capital account. We'll be figuring that out when we prepare the next account title. Let's go on to the second entry. The second entry refer to equipment purchased. So equipment account debit to cash account to accounts payable. So on the debit side of equipment account, we'll have to cash account and to further accounts payable. Let's note that down. Similarly, when we talk about equipment's account being debited and the specific accounts being credited, that is to cash and to accounts payable, in the next sheet, when we prepare the cash and the accounts payable, we'll be crediting that same journal entries, that means to equipment, both in the cash and the accounts payable. We'll be reiterating the credit entries right now so that we can further understand how the specific account is supposed to be prepared. Now we'll be just mentioning about all these three account titles. So the second entry has been done. Let's go on to the next entry. The next entry is accounts payable to cash. The reason being, there has been certain payment which has been made towards accounts payable. Now both the account titles are not created. So let's go on to the entry in the later part. The last entry would be drawings account to cash. The reason being, again, drawings is a withdrawal that has been done for personal usage for rupees 500. We have already created drawings account. On the drawing debit, we'll be mentioning to cash account. And on the credit side, we'll be mentioning by drawings account, which will be under the cash category. So in the drawings account, on the debit side, to cash rupees 500. So we have prepared the three account titles. We'll further go and prepare the next two account titles, which will mark the closure of journal entries and the closure of ledger balances. Let's figure that out. So we'll reiterate the first entry again. cash account debit to capital account. Now, in the capital account, we had credited by cash. Similarly, in this specific cash account, we'll be debiting to capital account. Let's do that. Now, in the second entry, we had debited equipment account to cash to accounts payable. Similarly, here in a cash account, we'll be crediting to equipments. That means equipments account will be credited in this thing. We'll refer the same amount that has been mentioned towards the cash account. And similarly, under accounts payable, we'll be also mentioning by equipments account to the balance 7,000. Let's go on to the third entry. The third entry mentioned accounts payable account debit to cash account 3,000. Hence, cash account will be credited, or the cash account credit side will have accounts payable 3,000 and accounts payable debit side will have to cash account 3,000. Let's figure that out and let's mention that thing in the journal entries and as per the ledger balances. So we have mentioned the third journal entry as well. Now the last entry, that means drawings account debit to cash. Drawings account or the drawings account debit has been already mentioned with to cash account. In the cash account, we'll be also further mentioning by drawings account with the date and the amount. So this is how you prepare the specific journal entries and the ledger account balances, and this is how you post the ledger balances further and close the balances. Just to give you an example, we'll close accounts payable balance here and we'll figure out how much balance is left. If you can see, I've highlighted on two boxes. One, the balance amount 4,000, which has been carried forward on October 1st. This is how you close a specific ledger account. So if you can see, the balance that is shown on the debit side, that means the shortage of that much amount will be then carried forward on the credit side, because that is something that is still a liability that has to be paid. Hence, it is coming on the balance opening on the credit side. Similarly, every such account will be closed further, and the same balance which has been highlighted here, I'll highlight that in red, that will be shown in trial balance. The underlined amount will be shown in trial balance with the account title accounts payable on the credit side. So we know trial balance has particular debit credit. On the credit side, accounts payable title 4,000 balance. This is how the trial balance is supposed to be prepared. So that's when you understand how a specific trial balance is prepared and how a specific trial balance can be helped or can be prepared using ledger balances. So when we talk about illustration, this is the illustration that you can further refer to for creation of journal entries and then preparation of ledger balances. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.